So I go on Brando, pick up the, hey. Now do me that, you know. You hear that music there? Official.
Brando, war report. You wake up, you know. All right, let me call him on the phone. Let me call him on the phone, you see, because he not the on Skype. Yo.
Yo, yo, brother.
I'm there. Yo, war report.
Put the camera.
What?
Go on. Wala. Let me put the camera. Wala. Because people want to see. You have the camera on?
One second there. Let me make sure I tune up the thing and make sure everything moves, bamba.
You see. No worry, man. Get ready. We live and direct on Clashology, you know. And that's how we stay, you know. Clashology is live and direct. No fuckery. You know, we no record. Nothing at all.
No shimmings.
Yeah, no shimmings. You see, I'll be a shampoo. Big up Jawil, you know. Boy, Jawil went to New Jersey, you know. You know, see what I want in New Jersey, you know. England there, you know. Big up Jawil, you see it. Big up, I'm there. Five star, hold on. Let me set it. All right, so people can see you properly, seeing. All right. Welcome, me brother.
Respect, man. Manners and respect, man. Big up, Mr. Wari.
Yeah, man, bigger Brando, you know. So, cool. I don't know. Sorry.
And big up to everybody in the studio, too.
Bless up.
Give thanks, my brother. Manners, you see it. Yeah, man. Because I youth there from England. And England have manners, you see it. I mean, know that. Listen, we just talked to King Shane, man.
Yeah.
And yesterday, I was on War Report, and you talked to Empire.
Yeah.
So I needed to call you, you know. I needed to talk to you because King Shine say, I'm ready for England. Him say, I'm not go no shimmings in England, you know. Him know the thing, you see it. Him I catch the words, you know. Him know everything. Him tell me, say, him have the slang and everything. But yesterday you talked to Empire, and actually Empire is a son. Is a son with Clash. He clash a lot, right?
Yeah.
They have the World Clash coming up. They have this clash against King Shine, you know. So I must be some real, real hearts on that, you know. Yeah, man.
Empire doing their thing, man. They're representing right, man, and flying the flag still. You know what I mean? As you know, one of the sounds, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So we have to give Empire their glory. They're putting in the work right now. They've been putting in the work, and you know what I mean?
Yeah, man.
Story comes about doing their thing right now.
Yeah, man, and I think it's always good when you clash a top sound, you know, because no matter what happened, you know, if you give a good battle, you play the tune them, it's all about leave a good impression to the massive. You might lose the clash, but the people will say, boy, I went to the dance, so I'm listening to the audio, and the sound went hard. You see, him trying best, but then he lose the clash, right?
True.
You see it? All right. You know, I'm going to ask you something still, you know, because you playing Saxon.
Mm-hmm.
You know the amount of people who are asking me, whoa, how can I book Saxon?
Yeah, but Saxon is available, man. You know what I mean?
For what? For what? Be precise.
100%, man. You get me? Saxon is on the clash front, you know what I mean? We're not clashing, so to speak, at the moment right now, but we will be back on the back of field soon.
I hope so, man.
At the moment it's just you know, juggling at the moment still.
You know what I mean? Yeah, man, you're taking double showcase. Yeah.
Back on the grounds, you know what I mean? Because, you know, it's requested right now. People want to see Saxon back on the back of field and thing, you know what I mean? As a legendary sound and thing. So,
yeah, as a matter of fact, you know, when I put your name on the flyer, when I say, someone send me a message and say, hey, there's a friend shooting, and say, hey, what about Saxon? You know, because, you see, yeah, the mute, you're a real fan of Saxon, you know. Our friends love Saxon son from way back when, you know, because that song from the 70s, people don't even know. Is it? Is that song where set the trend, you know, from way back when, broke a lot of style, a lot of DJs, you know, a beer things, real sound. No shimmings. Man.
Yeah, man, definitely. But yeah, man, Saxon's available, man, you know what I mean? So those who want to book, it's not a problem, man.
You know, man, it's a good look. Definitely, man. Me glad to see some new generation attack on some old sound, you know, and I carry the legacy, you know, because at that it's supposed to be, you know.
Yeah, man. Definitely, man. 100%, man. You know what I mean? That's how it's supposed to be. You know what I mean? When you have a sound and it's a foundation sound, you're supposed to keep up. generation wise in terms of having the selectors and that can you know carry on the legacy, because legacy doesn't stop at one era, you understand? Yeah. So you know, the legacy can't stop at the 80s, it can't stop at the 90s. You have to keep on going, you have to keep incorporating the generations of today to keep your sound relevant to today's movement. You know what
I
mean?
Of course, 100%. That's why I big up Father Ethan from King of These. Cause a lot of people are talking bullshit, but he might get apply to the, even if the youth take time for bus and thing, him still push the youth them and give them confidence. Exactly. Yeah, man.
Definitely.
It's a long road, because busing a song which have such reputation and history is not an easy thing for doing, you know? You see? Yeah. But you see, the chemistry start to take with Kingpin right now when it gone wicked. But on the juggling side, it bad. So on the way, you know?
When you join a sound, you know, you have to find your foot. You understand? And sometimes it takes a time where you find your foot and find your gear. And, you know what I mean? You learn your box, and the more dances you play, the more experiences you get. So... yeah, man, him finding foot now and him finding gear. So, you know, at first, you know, you got a lot of people criticizing, and, you know, it's all a part of the game. People criticize, people say what they want to say, but it's you as the individual, you have to stay positive and do what you need to do in your own time.
Yeah.
And you're good to go. And now he's found his foot, he's doing his thing. He's one of the baddest jugglers in America, to me.
All right. I'm glad you say that, because you know what? When we used to be Pon Pal Talk, I remember enough of them youth used to be Pon Pal Talk, and they used to train hard. Some youth did a bad mind Pal Talk, but look here now. Kingpin did Pon Pal Talk. Killer D, Super Fresh, D Easy, all of them, you know? Even I recruit from friends in the Pon Pal Talk. Sentinel, Supersonic, At Ruler, Bass ADC, you name it, you know? It used to be the spot where you can come here, so you have some big sound and you can train yourself. And we used to clash each other with 45s. And this is how we learn, you know. And and Jimmy Spliff used to be Pon Pal Talk. Enough of them youth where you say right now upon the battlefield, I bust up the place, used to come upon this. You see it?
Yeah, man. Yeah, man. For real. No, man. Definitely. Definitely. You have to start somewhere, you know, brother. So, you know?
Yeah, man. Of course.
That was the platform to get yourself in gear, you know what I mean? And move on forward to do what they're doing now. They're playing in dances. They're jamming up big venues and doing what they need to do, you know what I mean? As big sounds now.
Yeah, they represent for the younger generation. And I think it's good, because we need some bridges between some old song where represent the first generation of fans, you see it? Mm-hmm. And then you bring young selectors, so it's kind of a bring some younger generation into it, you know, because right about now, it's not about the connect the younger generation into it. We can't bother say, all right, we old and we keep it to ourselves, you know. Sons Clash, we need to promote that to the younger generation now, you see, and I bring them into the dances eventually. Can enough of them in Europe go to a festival. All right, I'm going to talk. All right, Brando, hear this topic, you know. I want your opinion on this topic.
Because
enough big festival I keep in Europe, right? You have Summer Jam, you have Rototom, you have Willip of them, Reggae Gill. We can't name all of them, because the amount of festival we have here, so about reggae music is a mad something. But none of them not keep no official Sons Clash on the main stage or whatever. It's a problem. Then I promote no Sons Clash, you know. What's your view upon this?
Yeah, why is that though? I don't understand why they don't have any Sons Clash. But then I don't live in Europe, so obviously I don't know how big the clash scene is in Europe, why they don't incorporate it, because, you know, they could easily do it, but would the people gravitate to it? That's the thing. Is it big enough, or is it popular enough to be incorporated into the festivals? Would the people appreciate it? Now, you'd have to tell me more, because you're over there more, you know Europe market more than me.
Yeah, man, no, but it's a good observation, you know, because it's true that Sons Clash is not popular as it used to be. That is a real talk, you know. It's big. It's not that it's not popular as it used to be, but it's like nowadays people don't go to Sons Clash like it used to be. Enough of them are wait. You know, they're going to wait and get the audio the next morning or whatever, listen to the live stream or whatever, you see. So that's the problem we're facing too, you know. But all right, I will say that in France, Sons Clash are going good still. You can get up to 400 people in a good Sons Clash in France. Locally speaking, you know, if you get like two French songs, you see, you get 350, maybe 300 in some places, you know. So yeah, that's the regular turnout nowadays. Back in the days, it used to be like 800, 600, mad, you know, place, ram, you see. But yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so that's just my opinion on the festivals. I mean, they must not see the need to have a sound clash in it. That's how I look at it, because I think if they did, then one of them would have done it by now.
No, they used to. All right, some of them have tried it, but listen, look at Urban Salute now. Me don't know if it's true, right? Me just read the media like anybody else, right? And them say, say Muta Baruka himself say that show where them keep in a Urban Salute, the sons clash between Dynamic and Jack Scorpio. Them say, are they wickedest show that?
Them say that,
them say, wow, that show you're bad. So
that's the first time they've done something like that. So that was a trial and error thing, and it worked. You know what I mean? The people them did love it.
All right, you know, that's why me say, all right, maybe festival should try that, should give, because all right, you know what's the problem? I mean, like, festival have a huge audience anyway. So no matter, like, I mean, you can't put something new in it, it not go disturb nothing, because it's a huge audience, you know, we are talking about thousands of people, you see it?
Yeah, yeah.
All right, anyway, that was just the idea, you know, talking about some topic that maybe we should address right now, because we love Sons Clash, Sons Clash culture. You're the life on Clashology alongside Brando from War Report. Big up, Jawin. Anyway, you do it. War Report. Boy, all right, hold on. I have to ask you something still, you know, because you see, yesterday, we did that on the show, you know, and we see, we hear, we are listening keenly, you know, and we hear a lot of dub play it and play, you know. And you see, we did a listen to Rumble Talk, you know. I mean, ASA, they have dubs too, you know. So me, I wonder, you know, it could have been, you know, War Report against Rumble Talk, is it? Because somehow you have dubs, you see. All right, when you hear King Shine him say, it not make no sense, you have dub later, you not clash.
Yeah. Well, to be honest, you know, anything is anything, really, you know what I mean? If the vibe, if the whole thing is right, then yeah, why not? I mean, it's a vibe, isn't it? You know what I mean, so.
All right,
so
listen, I'll give you an idea. I'll give
vibe. But it's competition, it's competitiveness at the circuit. You know what I mean? It's the business, so, you know, to keep it like that, that could go on. You know what I mean?
All right,
so just the thing has to be right.
That would be wicked, actually, because it's a new thing. And listen to me, it's good for the promotion. And it could be like for the anniversary, because I know War Report been running since 2K15, right?
Yeah.
So you could have like 5 years. In September, it's going to be 5 years.
Yeah, 5 years, yeah.
Yeah, so that's a good look for the anniversary party. War Report versus Rumble Talk.
Well, to be honest, I wouldn't do it for the anniversary still, because we've got some other plans still, but we could incorporate it somewhere down the other line, or, you know, it could happen.
It's a good look, man. It's good. It's good still, you know.
we've got, you know, plans that we've already set in place already for the anniversary, you know what I mean? Because that's a special night, you know what I mean? You're celebrating 5 years, so I wouldn't want to clash on a night that I'm celebrating another year of the program, you know what I mean?
Definitely, man. I get that, man, of course. What is a good looking look? Enough people, you know how the things is set already, you know. Some people are chat, you know, but yeah, it's a good look. 5 years, man. Congratulations, you know. That is a very long time. Yeah, I appreciate that, you know. That means Sons Clash have a thing. People like it, you know. They want to hear about it. You see? And that means you guys talk sense and entertain the people. So I love that, man. Big up yourself, you know, Brando. You see it?
Yeah, man, as I'm respecting, you know. Big up Clash Allergy, you know. Yeah, I want to do a good job. You know. You know what I mean? Because it's not just, obviously, there's various platforms, you know, putting in the work and doing what they got to do. You understand? It's not a one-man thing. You lot's platform is good as well. Everybody that's doing something.
Definitely, my brother.
The industry and the business, they're for all a big up. You understand? I mean, no matter how small it is, no matter how big it is. You get me? Every contribution is, you know what I mean, is valid.
Yeah, man, I endorse that 100%, my brother. You know, nothing, you know, you talk the truth, strict. You see it?
We have to keep our art clean at the same time, you know, brother. So,
I saw it going on. Said, I saw it going
every
on.
Every input is valid.
It's valid, strict. You see it? I saw Mr., you know, one love, you know, because our reggae music, you know, it's bigger than we. You understand? Strict, man, you know. Manners and respect, you know, Brando. Yeah, man, respect for coming to the show. Endorse that, you know, War Report for life.
Hey, Dr. Wari and the full studio crew and the Clashology family, manners and respect, man. Thank you for having me on the program.
Respect, my brother. Respect. You see, when you hear what the man are talking of, when you listen what the man are talking of, the man say unity. You see it? The man say we fi keep together and I build this together, you know. You see, enough how to fight it, you know, but we together. Big up yourself, Brando, you know. Words of wisdom and we love that, you know. Yeah, man, one love. Big up.
Up.